Today we are going to compare a burr grinder to a blade grinder. A lot of people ask me that why is one better than the other? What is so special about a burr grinder other than being a fancy equipment for making coffee? Well, I need to explain. Now, a blade grinder has a chamber in it which contains a blade which runs at a ridiculously high RPM when it's grinding. What that means is that the grind that it produces is very uneven. Some of the beans that come in front of it get grinded very, very fine, while others are left a bit coarse. The result is that some of the particles hit the grinder and some don't, which produces a very uneven grind. Now you might be asking, why is that important? The coffee particle size has an effect on how water extracts coffee out of it. Water extracts coffee differently out of a particle which is small as compared to a particle which is big. The coffee is going to taste bitter, it's going to taste muddy, and it's going to be confusing at best. On the other hand, when a coffee goes through a burr grinder, each and every coffee goes through the same grinding procedure as every other bean. Your grind is very, very consistent. Well, that's what it aims to do. The more expensive your burr grinder is, the more consistent your grind is going to be.
For comparison, let's make a batch of filter coffee. I'm using an Arabica blend called Oro from S Cafe. You can get a pack of Oro from Daraz, from their website. You can get it from Uncle Tetsu. Links are all given in the description below. And I'll make my coffee with a ratio of 1:20, keeping it a little light. That means my ratio is going to be 15 grams of coffee to 300 grams of water. And let's see how it turns out.
Okay, so here we have our two coffees. This one is blade grinder, this one is the burr grinder. Now have a look at the difference of colors between the two. This looks severely under extracted. This is the right color, it's perfectly extracted. And if you have a look at the coffee beds in the end, you can see that the blade grinder has big chunks of coffee at the top of the filter, whereas this one is even throughout.
Now, despite the big chunks of beans present in the blade grinder, it took about 20 seconds longer for the extraction to happen. And that's mainly because the fine pieces, the really fine particles, and sort of block the filter. That makes the extraction become really slow.
Okay, so there's a lot of clarity in this coffee. There's a certain complexity of taste which is non-existent in this one. So obviously, a proper grind gives you a much better coffee profile, tasting profile, that is. So of course, my vote is with a proper coffee grinder. If you're a person who doesn't go to a cafe to drink your coffee, then a coffee grinder is not a bad investment. So what did you think about this video of ours? Do you have one of these at home? Do you have one of these at home? Have you had different results than me? Do you try checking the grinder and have you had different results? Do you get a better brew than mine? I would love to know your opinions in the comments below. For now, thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and have a great day.